Our mission and our target is to work out and calculate the distance from port A, which is right here where the crosshairs are, remember, from A, all the way down here to point B. So we're looking for how far south has this boat traveled. Now, we can work this out. We're going to do it in two steps. Step number one is we need to calculate what this angle in here is first. Now, we know when we go all the way around, it's 360 degrees. Now, from north to east, it's 90 degrees. Then from east to south, it's another 90 degrees. Altogether, that's 180 degrees. And then up here to west, it's 270 degrees. Now, that's too much for the 210, right? Because 210 just passes the 180. So how do we find that little gap in there? We're going to work that out in a second. And then step two, what we're going to do is we're going to work out, using trigonometry, this triangle here, it's a right angle triangle, we're going to work out specifically from port A all the way down to here, how far south that boat has traveled. So let's begin with point number one, step one, and that is to work out what this angle here is. Now that angle, I would call it CAB, okay? That's the angle in there. Let's work out CAB. So, angle CAB equals, now let's have a look here. The total amount all the way down to here, just south, going straight line, as we know a straight line angle is 180 degrees. Now just past 180 degrees down here, just past it is 210. So we want to know what this gap is in there. So the closest vertical is 180. So let's take that away from 210. That'll leave us what's in there. Okay, so let's do that. So that's going to be 210 degrees. Take away the vertical, which is 180 degrees. Let's do that. And that will leave us the gap. So 210, take away 180 on your calculator is going to yield an answer of angle CAB equals 30 degrees. Okay, cool, that's 30 degrees in there. Let me just mark it out. Okay, now it's basic trigonometry in this triangle here. It is a right angle triangle. We want to find out how far south from port A to that point down there. So how far south has this speedboat traveled? Let's work that out now. Well, the first thing I can see is that we have the distance here, which is kind of like the hypotenuse. That's 190 kilometers. And over here is the distance we're looking for. We don't have that yet. So we can kind of work that out because since we have that angle, and you can see this, what's next to 30 degrees on its, well, going down this way on its left, yeah, on your right. 30 degrees, well, that's going to be what? That's going to be adjacent, isn't it? So let's mark that out. So that's ADJ here. And over here, it's HYP, it's hypotenuse, isn't it? Okay, let's work this out. So it's adjacent over hypotenuse. Is that a sine, a cos, or a tan? It's a cos, that's right. So let's do that, cos 30 degrees. Let's work that out here. Cos 30 degrees, which is the same as that angle. Angle CAB is 30 degrees. So what's that going to be? Well, adjacent, we have, that's what we're looking for. So we want to find that, and that's AB. So let's write down AB. All over the hypotenuse, we know is 190 kilometers, yeah? Okay, now let's multiply both sides by 190. When we do that, we can leave the AB by itself. So let's do that. So times by 190 on this side, times by 190. Okay, cool. Now that's going to yield 190 times cos 30 degrees is going to give us AB. AB. Let's work this out, put this in the calculator. 190 times cos 30 degrees equals, that's going to give us to the nearest kilometer, the distance south from port A down to B equals 164.54 kilometers. And then we got to write in the direction and then we're finished.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.